We've always had differences among us as Christians, but never really in church history have we seen so many statistics that indicate that many Christians today are practicing actually what can only be described as Christless Christianity. In this segment, we're going to take a look at the claim that there is a Christless Christianity afoot and how pervasive it might be, not only in some churches, but really as a fog creeping through American pop spirituality. Today we see an emphasis on what would Jesus do over what has Jesus done. The focus seems to be, and I know I'm speaking in generalities here, but as we'll see in a moment, the statistics back this up. It seems that the diet people are getting today, all across American Christianity, is a to-do list. Whether it's in conservative churches where they have a conservative agenda or liberal churches where they have a liberal agenda, it's all about agendas, doing, not believing. A very prominent evangelical leader has argued that the first Reformation was all about creeds, getting our doctrine right. Now what we need is a new Reformation about deeds. We have our doctrine straight, but we're not living it. And what I want to challenge in this session is not the zeal of those who want to see us live godly lives in the world, but the belief, the assumption that we are believing the right things, but we're not living them. I think that we are living in a way that is consistent with our assumptions, that we are the center of the universe, that God exists to make us happy, that God has given in the Bible all sorts of rules, not really rules, but advice, helpful instruction, so that we can have our best life now. What I'm arguing here is not so much that American Christianity has become heretical, although certainly heresy is always near at hand when we don't think clearly about the gospel and when we are drawn into the pattern of this world's way of thinking. What I'm arguing, rather, is that we're being killed softly by the muzak in the background, the hum that draws us slowly but surely away from sin, the atoning work of Christ, His having propitiated the wrath of God, and our being justified by grace alone, through faith alone, in Christ alone. And that He applies this to us Himself by grace alone as the Spirit brings the gospel to us and creates faith and confirms that gospel through the sacraments. That is the message that I think is increasingly being assumed, if it's believed at all. And the next stage after you assume it long enough is to not believe it. At least that's what happens with the next generation. We focus on the felt needs of consumers rather than the real needs that God Himself identified in His Word. We focus on the inner self and our inner experience as the authority to tell us what's right and wrong, what's true and false, what's good and evil, what's beautiful and ugly. We look inside of ourselves, trusting that which we know deep down inside of ourselves. When God comes to us and says, I want to get you out of yourself. You're the problem. The further you go into yourself, the more you actually become a captive to your own bondage. And so He comes to us with an external word, an external gospel, external news, and says, put everything down, just sit down and receive. Receive my judgment and receive my grace.